former Manny Pacquiao destroyed Eric Morales in his last fight, he returned to his native Philippines as the conquering hero. Manny grew to megastar status that includes all sorts of commercial endorsements, along with music videos, his life story, and CDs. Music is one of Manny's many, many passions. When he signed to fight Oscar Larios, his nation embraced the event. Pacquiao knew he had a lot of work ahead of him just to get ready for the very formidable Oscar Larios. And for Larios, it's the opportunity of a lifetime. So the time has come for Pacquiao versus Larios, mano a mano. And this is the scene in the Philippines, in Manila, Quezon City. This is one place where they don't care about World Cup football. It's all boxing, and it's all non-stop Manny Pacquiao. This is Araneta Arena, of course, very famous 31 years ago, but tonight, it's all about Manny Pacquiao, the crowd in attendance, all sorts of security. It's like a Super Bowl, a World Cup football venue, the National Hockey League playoff, the NBA championship, and a championship fight all rolled into one. This is Araneta Coliseum, and you're here for Manny Pacquiao and Oscar Larios. And hello once again, everybody. I'm the Colonel Bob Sheridan, and I'm absolutely thrilled to be back here after 31 years. And I know Dave Montempo, we've already seen a host of great action so far, but nothing in comparison to what we're about to see with Manny Pacquiao.
Well, there's been great intensity with the fighters and the crowd, but that's just a few levels below what we're going to have, especially when the crowd sees Pacquiao in here. They're going to erupt in an ovation.
And do you see any way that Oscar Larios can upset this guy?
What he would have to hope for is that the icon who's in the middle of CDs and movies and books has forgotten about him. That's his best chance.
Manny Pacquiao has plenty of power, but Oscar Larios can really fight. Well, to add to the festivities, Michael Buffer, the great ring announcer, has joined us, and we're set to get underway with our national anthems, and we're set to go. So without further ado, let's go upstairs to our ring announcer, Michael Buffer. Michael, take it away.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, would everyone please rise for the national anthems of the respective fighters, challenger and champion. First, here to sing the national anthem of Mexico, please welcome Ms. Erika Alcocer.
Mexicanos al grito de guerra, el acero apresad y el bidón. Y retiembla en sus centros la tierra al sonoro rugir del cañón. Y retiembla en sus centros la tierra al sonoro rugir del cañón. Siño patria, tú tienes oliva de la paz, el arcángel divino, que el cielo tu eterno destino por el dedo de Dios escribió. Mas si osare un extraño enemigo profanar con su planta tu suelo, piensa, oh patria querida, que el cielo un soldado en cada hijo te dio, un soldado en cada hijo te dio. Mexicanos al grito de guerra, el acero apresad y el bridón. Y retiembla en sus centros la tierra al sonoro rugir del cañón. Y retiembla en sus centros la tierra al sonoro rugir del cañón.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing the national anthem of the Republic of the Philippines. Here to sing it, please welcome Bituin Escalante.
Bayang magiliw, perlas ng silanganan, alab ng puso, sa dibdib mo'y buhay, lupang hinirang, duyan ka ng magiting sa manlulupig. Di ka pasisiil sa dagat at bundok, sa simoy at sa langit mong bughaw, may dilagang tula at awit sa paglayang minamahal. Ang kislap ng watawat mo'y tagumpay, niya'y nagniningning ang bituin at araw na kailan pa may di magdidilim. Lupa ng araw na walhatid pagsinta, buhay ay langit sa piling mo. Aming ligaya na pag may mga api, ang mamatay na dahil sa'yo.
Electricity, and it's been building all week.
It's unbelievable. We're going to show you the weigh-in. Here it is. As Oscar Larios steps to the scales, and he scales him at 129. Thing bouncing around as Manny Pacquiao steps up, takes the shades off. And he, too, is right on the mark at 129, Manny Pacquiao. So the stage is set as we get ready for this big fight. It's a little bit after 11 o'clock in the morning here in the Philippines at Araneta Stadium. David, as you take a look at the tail of the tape, does it mean much?
Well, what it will show you is some numbers, but it will not show you the intensity, because that's going to be displayed in the ring. But as you take a look at these guys, biggest thing with Pacquiao and Larios is the fact that Larios is moving up in weight from where he'd been fighting at 122 pounds. He said it was very difficult to get down to that weight. So normally when you come up in weight, that's a disadvantage. He feels it's an advantage. So we will see how that plays out.
So Larios, the same reach, a little bit older, a little bit lighter, and a couple of inches taller. As the festivities continue inside of this crowd, is in anticipation. You know, it's not even for a world title fight. It's for the WBC International Super Featherweight Championship. But let's take a look at the rules under which this fight will be contested.
And our boxing fans will be familiar with 10 points to the winner of a round. No standing eight count, no three knockdown rule. A fighter cannot be saved by the bell at all. Only the referee can stop the fight, although physicians have input with them. In case of an accidental foul, we will go to the scorecards after the fourth round is complete, provided the bell is sounded for round five. After the beginning of that, you go to the scorecards. Before that, there is no verdict.
And there are a couple of other headbutt rules that, as they come into play, we'll explain them to you, as they did in the very last fight. So we'll be right on top of that as it unfolds here. So again, the stage becomes even more set as they begin to clear the ring. And the next order of business will be to actually move Oscar Larios to this ring, and we'll get this fight underway very, very shortly for you. So the big question, the distractions that Manny Pacquiao has had, is his power and his highly skilled speed and action going to be enough to offset it? Well, the people in attendance here absolutely love this Manny Pacquiao, and I don't know if I've been sort of belaboring the point, but it's just so unbelievable to me that this crowd in attendance, and this is only the live venue, There are some 7,000 movie theaters throughout this country on the some 7,000 islands that make up the Philippine Islands that are watching this in the movie theaters as well. So while Araneta, that a lot of people were surprised that they'd be able to sell it out because it scaled pretty high as a matter of speaking here in the Philippines, but it hasn't stopped the crowd from getting in here somehow.
Well, a lot of boxing superstars don't get the opportunity to come back to their home area to stage an event. It's always casinos, etc. But here, Manny Pacquiao was able to come back to his home.
Respect for Oscar Larios here. You don't hear any booing in the crowd, Dave. They respect good boxing, and they respect this guy, but they don't expect Chololo to be able to do anything against Manny Pacquiao. You talked about at the very top of the show, and again when we reset, the scenario by which Larios could win this fight.
He would have to hope that he could take this crowd and turn it against Manny Pacquiao, which is a huge thing. He would almost have to make this fight be a bit of a stinker if he's able to survive the early assault. Not much is expected of him here. That's good because there is no pressure on Larios. We'll see how he's able to handle Pacquiao's intensity throughout the fight.
This guy's a good fighter. He's coming up from 122 pounds, but in his case, at 29 years of age, he says that's a real plus for him because I didn't have to kill myself and weaken myself. He told me in his fight against Israel Vasquez, where he was stopped in the third round and got knocked down in the first round, that he was so weak trying to get down to the weight that he's been able to eat and feels real strong. Look at the profile.
Let's take a look at Chololo from Mexico, an orthodox fighter. He's had a lot of fun this week in the Philippines, a good 61-fight record coming up from 122 pounds. Big factor in this fight is what his chin will be like. First time he gets hit by Pacquiao, we will find out a lot about Oscar Larios. Colonel, it's refreshing to see a guy come in and not see a big entourage, as we've seen with some other fighters throughout boxing.
Especially for a fighter and an athlete that has people texting around town every place he moves, so that there's thousands of people knowing exactly every movement of Manny Pacquiao. That's why Freddie Roach, his trainer, had to get him out of the Philippines to train him for 4 or 5 weeks in Los Angeles before he came back here as the conquering hero once again. The guy's an absolute, I don't want to use the term god, but he did draw more than the Pope.
Yeah, and he's had people all over him this week, and he seemed to handle it with a good soft-spoken demeanor, Manny Pacquiao, the Pac-Man from right here in the Philippines, one of the most hardest-punching southpaws in boxing at the top of his professional career after the 41 fights. And great time. He's here in his 12th year of boxing and getting his due at this stage of his career.
So, again, the stage is now set, and we're just about ready to go. And now Michael Buffer is standing by, so let's go to the voice of champions, Michael Buffer. Go ahead, Michael.
Mabuhay, Pilipinas!
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Araneta Coliseum, where 31 years ago, two legends of the ring, Smoking Joe Frazier and Muhammad Ali, faced off in the greatest war in heavyweight history, the Thriller in Manila. Today, two warriors step into the ring to honor that great event. As ABS-CBN Broadcasting Corporation and ABS-CBN Global present Mano a Mano, the Thriller in Manila 2. 12 rounds of boxing for the WBC International Super Featherweight Championship. Promoted by Manny Pacquiao Promotions in association with Golden Boy Promotions. Sanctioned by the Republic of the Philippines Games and Amusement Board Chairman Eric R. Buhain, WBC International Supervisor from Italy, Mauro Betti. The three judges at ringside scoring this contest on the 10-point system from France, Humbert Forgoni. From Thailand, Nofarat Svicharoen. And from Belgium, Daniel Vandeville. And when the bell rings, the man inside the ring, in charge of the action, referee Bruce McTavish. And now for the thousands in attendance and the millions watching around the world, from Asia to Australia, from Europe to Africa, from South to North America. Ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to rumble! Fighting out of the blue corner, wearing blue with white, official weight 129 pounds. Professional record, 56 victories, including 36 knockouts, 4 defeats, with 1 draw. Damas y Caballeros de Guadalajara, Mexico, the challenger, former 2-time world champion, Oscar Chololo Larios. And fighting out of the red corner, wearing white with red flames. Official weight, 129.5 pounds. Professional record, 41 victories, including 32 knockouts, 3 defeats with 2 draws, from General Santos City. 3-time world champion, reigning, defending WBC International Super Featherweight Champion, the fighting pride of the Philippines, Manny Pacquiao.
So the introductions are done, and we're ready for action. Mano a mano.
That's all.
The referee is Bruce McTavish.
Everybody else out of the ring, please. Manny, Oscar, you can give your instructions. Obey my commands at all times. Touch gloves.
All right, we're set for round one. This is scheduled for 12. It's for the WBC International Super Featherweight Championship of the World. It's at 130 pounds. Manny Pacquiao decked out in the white trunks with all kinds of sponsorship trim. And in the blue trunks with the white trim is Oscar Larios. Larios has got to be careful in the early going because we expect Manny to go right after him. Here we go, round number one. Pacquiao again in white to the right of your screen. Larios goes with the first punch of the fight as he gets that jab out there, and he's got to hold him off of the jab. Remember, anything that Pacquiao does, you'll hear a roar of the crowd. Manny with the chin tucked and his eyes up, hands held high, looking for his opportunity to land his first punch as Larios goes with his first shot of the fight.
Larios will be trying for a right-hand lead on Manny, which he'll have to pop in there because Manny Pacquiao has such a good, strong left hand. He'll try the right-hand lead, double left hook. That will be throughout the course of the fight. But his early modus operandi is to get through these early rounds and try to drag this into late territory.
That's really his only hope with the Wayne McCullers, I pointed out. The great fighter that Wayne is, Wayne didn't possess the punching power that Pacquiao is possessing. So in reality, Larios could throw caution to the wind and just mix it up and hope the better man was standing at the end of those two fights with Wayne because he couldn't knock him down either. But in this case, he's got to really be cautious, keep the jab in the face of Manny Pacquiao and make sure he doesn't get clipped like he did in his last fight against Israel Vasquez. But Manny, he'd like to finish it as quick as he can because there's a huge payday looming for him. And that is, of course, in the third fight with Eric Morales. And I'm sure Bob Arum is tuned in today in Las Vegas. And you can be sure his heart is in his mouth, hoping nothing happens to Manny. Like a broken hand or cut or anything that could mess up that fight scheduled for the MGM in Las Vegas.
Larios needs to be moving more. He's staying in front of Pacquiao. He needs to be moving side to side so that Pacquiao cannot settle into an attack.
Unless Pacquiao with an attack, and he's not able to really land anything. And there's no reach advantage, although Larios was a bit taller. Looks like he has an advantage in reach, but in reality, he doesn't. Body shots exchanged by both guys. Manny hasn't been able to land the left-hand power shot, and he'd like to try and get one on the chin before the end of this first round. But there's only 54 seconds to go. Here's Manny. Cuts him a couple of times with light left hands. That's his powerful shot for the southpaw. And again, you watch Larios work from a distance, and this is the perfect fight for him. By the way, he doesn't even need to win the first two or three rounds. He's got to survive them and get by them and then try to outbox Pacquiao in the later rounds in the fight.
He'll be trying to move to his left, which is good, so he gets away from the power shot of the left-handed fighter. Although Pacquiao has talked about this week, he has more power in his right hand now, so let's see if that comes into play during this fight. But Larios has to go to kick him away.
Now here they go and mix it up a little bit. It's Manny that dictates that as he goes hunting downstairs. He wants to blast the body. If he can't reach the head, he wants to blast the body. Manny faints, bounces side to side, sets himself up, faints again. And a faint's as good as a light jab, a positioning jab sometimes. Now he rolls the jab out there, slides around, and the bell ends round number one. Pacquiao really didn't do much. You may have to give the first round to Larios.
Sure.
I give it to Larios on my score sheet because Manny really didn't do much, but see what he could do with this guy. Tested him a little bit to the left, a little bit to the right, tested his movement, so ring generalship might go to Pacquiao, but on the score sheet, I got to go with Larios.
Well, Pacquiao is trying to measure what he will be able to do during the course of this fight, and he gets a premonition here of what's going to be available as he's able to go down and score with a right hand. Trust me, it was there.
It definitely was there as Freddie Roach talks to Manny. Runs a very controlled corner. Everyone is screaming and yelling, and Freddie tries to leave his man with just one thought. All right, here we go. Round number two. I'm the Colonel Bob Sharden with Dave Bontempo. We're in Araneta, the Coliseum, Quezon City, Manila, the Philippines. And it's just a little after 11:30 in the morning here on a Sunday. Well, you're watching around the across the United States. It's Saturday night, and I hope you're enjoying your Saturday night at home with us. Terrific boxing so far, and this is a strategic match so far. But one punch from Manny can change the course of this momentarily. And you see Larios, he's going to kick up the right hand, and now he's straight. He caught him with the left hand. The left hand power shot by Larios. By Pacquiao, spun the head of Larios.
He has some early trouble here in round two as the Pac-Man has jumped on him now.
This is the way we expect to see Manny in the first round, but he kind of cruised through the first round, testing his movements and getting his positioning. Larios looked almost awkward, reaching with his right-hand power shot there, and it doesn't do anything to Manny Pacquiao. It doesn't even get positioning for Larios. Manny in front of him now, moving the hands up and down, looping right hand. Manny faints away, spins to his right, and takes a punch.
And Larios stood up and took one shot. He has to stand in at some point and try to get Pacquiao to respect him a little. But the key thing for him, keep the movement. When he stopped with the movement, he stopped long enough that Pacquiao nailed him.
Long stop in front of him. Nice side-to-side movement by Larios, forcing Pacquiao to miss. And there he is, keeping the jab and keeping Manny Pacquiao honest. Remember, Freddie Roach told us that he also possesses power in his right hand now that Larios may not expect, and if he slides around and gets too close without throwing punches, he could be nailed with a right hook, in this case, for the southpaw fighter. And he gets it inside, blast to the body and back upstairs.
Larios gambled from the outside to try and score with his right hand, and that's why he got nailed.
He got caught, he
made
his fight. He's opening up in round two, and he's got Larios reeling a little bit. You see those knees are a little bit jellied in them right now. And you see the legs start to go, and they did start to go. He's not out on his feet, but he's back on his heels a little bit more now, and his legs a little bit heavier. And now the wide stance as he bounces and lands a right hand of his own, but it doesn't hurt Manny Pacquiao.
No, but at least he was able to score with it. He fired it from the right spot. Larios cannot afford to throw a right hand and be short.
Well, that time he wasn't. He got the good looking right hand out there, and he has his legs back again. Good bounce back in the knees. A little bit of jelly in the knees just for a second with Larios. And he's able to weather the storm with 19 seconds to go in the second round. Manny must feel that he can do what he wants, and he decides to open up. And he hits an uppercut in there with a left hand. But he's okay. His legs are okay. But Manny's getting more confident as the seconds tick away. We're in the closing seconds of round two. The bell ends the second round. So Pacquiao turns it up a notch for round two and wins it. Oscar Larios felt some pain in the second round.
Pacquiao jumped on him and scored with his power shots. And showed the hand speed and his versatility. Coming inside, Larios going straight back, which is not what he wants. Fortunately for Larios, he caught a couple on the shoulders. And so the effect wasn't as bad as it looked, even though it looked pretty bad. But Pacquiao closing the distance.
Bruce McTavish, the referee, came over and said there was a headbutt. It was not intentional. There was no cut, so no damage, no pain, no loss of points. But the heads are coming together, which I'm glad Bruce indicated that he's on top of that. This is a very good referee, a veteran of over 100 championship fights, as both a referee and a judge. His Larios is trying to pick it up and trying to get back to the back of the field. So Larios touches him with a left hand. He's on top of him. I don't think he's hurt him, but he caught him with a good left hand.
He showed up with that left hook, Colonel.
Yes,
he's got a chance here.
He got hit him with the right hand, and now Manny's eyes look like, you know, he did catch him with that.
What a chance for Larios.
Straight right hand has Manny Pacquiao back on his heels. Now Manny puts his gloves together as much as say, no, it didn't hurt me, but in fact, he was shaken up by that shot. The opening left hook and then the right hand behind it. Manny's jaw's hanging down a little bit, and he's a little heavy of foot right now.
Well, Larios has been lurking in the weeds here all week, waiting for one chance in this fight. He finally scored with the right hand and the left hook early in this round.
And here comes Manny on the assault now, and he hasn't landed a clean blow in that exchange. But of course, most of the crowd has seen it so far back. Any of these grazing punches or looping shots look like they're hitting, and of course, the crowd goes crazy, so don't be fooled by that. Straight right hand again by Larios, almost clutch to the chin. So Larios, and as far as his confidence is concerned, where he shook Manny up in the early seconds of this round, has all of his confidence back there.
Yeah, the good right hand there, the left hook, and he showed that he could slug, but he still has to be properly timed as far as taking his chance.
And here's a hand speed, and now Larios decides to plant and he wants to mix with this guy. This actually is a mistake, but he nailed him with such a good shot, he feels like he can mix with him now, and that might prove to be his downfall. Manny clipped him with a straight right hand. Nice left hook. In his case, it's a left cross, a left-hand power shot. and the chant begins, Manny, Manny. But again, anytime Manny does anything well, the crowd, you know, they love this guy here. Larios has come to fight. Oh, he got hit with a pretty good right hand that time. And another right on the chin. Larios' legs are still okay, so he's ready to exchange.
But now Manny Pacquiao is moving after he hits Larios, so he is inventing some new angles to come at him with, and that was an effective exchange for Pacquiao.
Looping right hand catches the ear of Pacquiao. Pacquiao again bangs those gloves together as much as to say, come on, let me get this thing going. I want to get this guy out of here. Things aren't going all that well. The front feet get tied up that time, as you see, for the southpaw and a right-handed fighter.
And to tie in with what was being said earlier, now there's a cut opened up around the eye area of Larios. So remember, there was a headbutt in the last round.
But he wasn't cut, so if this is by a glove, it doesn't make any difference. It does involve the accidental headbutt. We'll get that ruling from the referee. He got nailed with a good right-hand shot that time. So we have seen flashes of the right hand that Freddie Roach has talked about. So what started out is almost a disaster for Manny turned back around in his favor.
And Bruce McTavish telling us that the cut opening up from a punch. So a critical decision made by the referee does not tie in with the determination he made one round earlier. So if that cut leads to the undoing of Larios, it is going to be a knockout victory, a technical knockout victory for Pacquiao.
Now, we should point out that Oscar Larios has one of the very best cut men in the world working with him in Miguel Diaz. Watch this action of Larios early in the round. Watch this day. This is something else. Wow.
Well, this is where Larios shows up and makes his presence in this fight. The left hook was big in this round. Right hand sneaking through. He gets Pacquiao backing up the right hand. That's the best shot right there. The left hook coming through as he kept his momentum. Look at the leverage. He tried everything here. Larios had his chance. He went with it.
All right, here we go. This is round number four. It's scheduled for 12 rounds. It's the WBC International Super Featherweight Championship. Larios made a statement and may have won on some of the judges' scorecards the third round, because I think Pacquiao was hurt more than he eventually hurt Larios, and this is about the hurt business at the professional level. So I gave Larios the first and third rounds. But things are going well for Manny Pacquiao at this stage. He cracked him with the right hand. Dave, how about you in the third round?
I went with Larios there based on that early assault and what he was able to withstand against Pacquiao. Got him winning two of the first three rounds, and what he has done is put himself in a position we talked about before the fight, where here he is now in the fourth round, legs under him in the fight. Now it's a question of, can he go to another level?
Well, we'll see. But Larios has done what he said he had to do, and that's survive the first three and we're into the fourth. Manny is the only one that's really been visibly shaken. Well, at one stage, he did catch Larios. His legs were a little bit loose.
And they look a little loose again.
Now, he got cut pretty good with that shot. But he still got the bounce with a straight left hand. That looked better than what it was. And now he's got Larios in the bounce over here. And he comes right back. Larios is in great physical shape at this point. Elsewise, he wouldn't be able to gobble this up.
He talked about training in Japan. He went away from his family for 6 weeks. He focused in an area where he's been on the road and won decisions, and he is in terrific condition to withstand this and keep himself in this fight.
And Bruce McTavish very concerned about the heads coming together, and we expected that because both guys sort of wag their heads, and they're bound to have cuts, and we have one by the left eye of Alario. The great thing, as I mentioned just before you did the last replay, Dave, was that we have Miguel Diaz, one of the great cut men in the corner of Larios, and that could become a factor if this fight goes many more rounds. Looping right hand taken mostly on the gloves by Manny Pacquiao. That left hand gets through. And again, the referee says, keep the hands up. Out with the right hand, right back comes Manny Pacquiao. Manny sort of plodding on his legs from time to time, Dave.
Well, you know, he's been waiting for one big opportunity rather than working his way in. He's an explosive guy who can maximize chances, but Larios a little taller, able to keep him off at times, and so Pacquiao has to decide he wants to work for that opening before he will get it.
There's the slip movement now by Manny as he's trying to clip him, and on top of that left eye, nice stiff jab by Larios. Remember, Dave and I gave Larios the first two rounds, and who do you give that round to?
Well, I'm going to give the Pacquiao.
Yeah, I would too. So the fight's dead even after four. But important now, as we take a look at that cut, remember, before this goes to the scorecards, we must hear the bell for the fifth round. In fact, it becomes a factor.
No, but that's not a butt there. So if this is the end of the fight, if this is the end of the round, this would be the end of the fight if he can't continue because of that particular cut.
That's right, too, because the referee ruled that
that's a punch.
It was a punch, that's right. So in that case, we would go to the scorecards. Absolutely right, Davis. Take a look at this.
Here's Pacquiao opening up. Larios saying, bring it. And Pacquiao saying, you bet I will. Coming with shots pouring through here. When Larios is moving straight back, he's a big target. Pacquiao had things going, but there's a ton of heart and courage here by Larios.
Well, both of us gave Larios 1-3 and Pacquiao 2-4. This is round 5 at Araneta Coliseum, Quezon City, Manila, the Philippines. Bob Sheridan here with Dave Bontempo, the principals, you know them, Manny Pacquiao and Oscar Larios. Larios in the blue, Pacquiao in the white. Larios fighting strategically, I think a terrific fight to this point. Manny wants to turn up the pace because I don't think Freddie Roach's game plan has him wanting to go into the middle rounds of this fight, much into the late, much less the late rounds of this fight. Because then this thing turns kind of around where Larios begins to have a shot if he continues boxing the way he's been boxing through the first four rounds.
This guy that's come up said he had trouble making weight other places. He's taken the intimidation factor out of this fight. That was big step number one. Pacquiao now has to bob and weave a little bit, work his way to get to the inside, and work for that opening. He's expecting it to just be there, but he has to work more for it.
Pacquiao trying to pot shot him right now, and as I say that, Larios rips a shot to the body, and right back comes Manny. Manny has a lot more bounce in his legs in this round than what he looked like in the last round, even though we gave him the last round. Just a little bounce in his fall right there. He loves to come after a guy, doesn't he?
He likes to do a little crossover step and then land a couple of quick shots. And Larios has been able to negate a lot of that by moving to his left. With Larios moving to his left, he stays away from the patented power hand of Pacquiao.
We've seen some success with the right hand of Pacquiao tonight as well. So Larios is going to stay right with his fight plan. Keep the jab going. There's a sneaky left hand lead that snapped the head back of Larios.
That's a special thing that Pacquiao did. He's moving one direction. You move with him to try to cut him off. He stops in the middle and pops you coming in. And that is what a good move is to set a guy up.
And he did it again with that straight left hand again. And that's a kind of a tailor-made Pacquiao fight plan when you go with that straight left hand. This guy is getting smarter all the time in the ring, too. He's not just out there. To a lot of us watching and a lot of people watching, it looks like these guys just go out there and wail away and may the best man win. But there's a lot of thinking now going on for Manny. He's setting up shots better. He hasn't been as wild as we've seen him in other fights. He's been aggressive all right, but he looks like a smart guy out there, more of a chess match, and picking his shots to engage. And when he does, for the most part, he's been successful. In the meantime, Larios doing a nice job. Manny on the start, he's a little bit short. Larios doing a nice job in his feet.
Yes, moving well, holding off Pacquiao, and even though he did not get a lot of offense going in this round, you know, you come back and try to get the next one, keep yourself in the fight. But that little move by Pacquiao has scored twice now in this round. It's like a misdirection play, and then he scores with a good, powerful left hand.
I like that, Dave, a misdirection play. That's exactly what it is, too, the way he snaps off to one side and then lets it fly. The bell ends the fifth round, and that's a Pacquiao round. And I assume you believe that, too.
Absolutely.
So now, with Larios winning 1-3, and we've given Manny 4-5, Manny's starting to watch boxing in the knee. Referee goes in and has a look at the cut by the eye of Larios.
Watch Pacquiao work to get that left hand through. There he did it sort of a lead left hand. And then watch the little move to one way, and then he gets him through. He leans to the right side. He gets his opponent moving, and then he scores and gets out of there. Larios saying, what is that?
Terrific stuff. We want to thank our director, Abbott Ramos, and the executives from ABS-CBN Broadcast Company, Eugenio Gabby Lopez, and of course our good friend Peter Musni from ABS-CBN, who's a coordinating producer here in the Philippines. We appreciate all their efforts. This is round number 6, Pacquiao and White. Larios, Oscar Larios from Mexico, Guadalajara in the blue trunks. A pretty good fight so far, although Manny's out in front now on my score sheet by just 1 point at the 5. This is round 6 from Araneta Coliseum. This is the attack of Manny Pacquiao. Nothing big landed, though. It looked better to the people afar than it was up close. That one popped the head back of Oscar Larios.
Even though it looked better than it was for Pacquiao, it shows that he makes this move. He can start getting inside and scoring with that move. And he'll just find a way to hone it, make it work better, and then maximize that opportunity. He is moving more now, and now with him moving, he's negating the movement of Larios.
Yeah, and he does a nice job, and he lands. He skips around to his right side, to his right shoulder, and gets set up to throw another punch. And if he gets that left hand down of Larios, he can drop it right on top of where Larios has already cut. And again, as Dave pointed out in the last round, that was ruled by a glove, so there's no accidental headbutt involved here at all in the scoring of this fight. It's going to go to the scorecards, who's ever ahead.
And their feet got tangled up, so the referee making a note of that. Happens a lot with righties and lefties as they're looking for positioning.
And part of the job for both the right-hand and the left-handed fighter when they're fighting the opposite is to get the front foot outside. Manny And once again, the condition of Larios shows because his knees didn't go and his head was knocked. Wow, look at that. Wild shot.
He was drilled with those shots, and that's the best combination punching Pacquiao has done in this fight.
And that left eye, we've got to keep an eye on it as Bruce McTavish is, because it's beginning to split open as we see more blood. And now you notice the lack of power by Larios because of the extraordinary power of Pacquiao that becomes so obvious. His Manny, uppercuts, left hook. And bangs and punches to the side of the head. That one on the jaw. Rips another one to the side of the head. Blasts him to the body. Now he's softening up after Larios. This is Manny Pacquiao. But look at the way Larios battles back. This is what's making it a fight.
Larios needs to tie up when Pacquiao gets up there like this. Don't try to win the exchange if it's not there. Tie up, try to come back later, because Pacquiao is surging into another level.
Round 6 action with 25, 24, 23 seconds to go. And Manny really dominating round 6 now. He's had good rounds, but this is a very dominant round for Manny Pacquiao. As I say that, Larios tries to load up and blast with a big right hand and comes back with a left. Manny comes off the ropes and says, hey, come on, come on. Here he goes with that left hand power shot, tries to catch him with the right, lands the left hand, the straight left, and the bell ends it. Good, good 6th round for Manny Pacquiao. Well, a lot of people didn't think it would go this far, but it goes a lot to the conditioning of Larios. But as you look into the face of Larios, he looks now for the first time like a beaten fighter.
Pacquiao able to turn it up, and then watch the hand speed that comes with the power. Now he's putting 4 and 5 shots together and getting Larios unable to react to that. When you put a lot of hand speed in front of a guy and then cut to the side, there's no reaction time for him.
Well, we're coming up to the 7th round. A lot of the local aficionados didn't expect this to get out of 3 rounds. Many predicted a 1st to 2nd round knockout. But in the 7th round, we'll see if Manny can continue what he's done, and that's trying to break down Larios. He did a good job in the 6th round of doing exactly that. Larios to the left of your screen, in the blue. In the white is Manny Pacquiao, the 3rd man in the ring, Bruce McTavish, the referee from New Zealand. He lives here, by the way, in the Philippines.
Now we're seeing the Pacquiao jab doubling up, and that wasn't there for him earlier. So everything is opening up now for Pacquiao as Larios has slowed a bit.
He's got to be frustrating a bit for Larios. Oh, man, he's hit. And now he scores a knockdown to drop up to 3 and 4 and 5.
step back.
Now Larios is doing what he has to and trying to tie up just to stay in this thing and then fire some right hands. But when you fire the right hand again, you cannot be short, because if you are and you don't bring it back, Pacquiao will nail you with that counter.
And that's exactly what he did, and Larios felt it and down he went. Only a flash knockdown. He was able to jump back up. But he's beginning to show some fatigue, and he's in great physical shape. But Manny Pacquiao is landing power shots out. The head was down, and now he hangs up. Now the legs are a little loose in the knees again. Watch his legs, folks, and that'll tell you where the head and the body's going. Here's Manny loading up shots. Big shots. He better answer, or the fight's in danger of being stopped. Manny landing several unanswered punches right now. He started to break him down in the sixth, and he's finishing it here in the seventh, as Larios has already been down once here in the seventh round. And Bruce McTavish looks into the eyes of Larios to make sure he's okay.
Still a lot of time for Larios to get through in round seven with a guy like Pacquiao coming right at him now.
Don't hit him,
as far as I'm concerned, all the questions about distractions and being in his home territory, he's answered that to this point so far. Manny can handle it. Yeah, great kid, by the way, as is Larios. Manny's a wonderful, wonderful person, and so far he's been able to handle this huge adoration and success that his career has given him coming from the four streets. Larios' legs are all right, but they're certainly a lot more loose in the knees than he was a couple of rounds ago.
He's firing these shots, and now firing and getting caught.
Yeah, he got pummeled by that right hand shot that time. And I see what Freddie Roach is talking about, that Manny can come forward, that left shoulder, and show a lot of power now with his right hand. There's another right hand shot to follow, and the left. And now Larios' legs don't look solid. He has to separate them very well to stand up. And he has nailed him. Larios gets the eye up the back, and the referee gets in there and takes that up over his shoulder. That's a terrific round of boxing and a 10-8 round for Manny Pacquiao.
Very near the end, he has an excellent chance to get a stoppage in the following round, because Larios may not have the ability to hold him off anymore.
1 point deduction, he hurt me.
Pacquiao pouring shots through after Larios misses. Now there's a knockdown in this round. Watch Larios on the outside, and he gets caught with a short, crisp shot as he leaves it there. You leave it there, Pacquiao will make you pay. The left hand nails him. He continues to work. Pacquiao pouring through on the inside throughout that round.
Let's go, Miguel.
They're coming up to round number eight. This is scheduled for 12. Araneta Coliseum in Manila, the Philippines. The site of the thriller in Manila 31 years ago, Ali Frazier. They call him this here locally, the thriller in Manila too. And Manny Pacquiao, to this point, has not disappointed his millions of fans here in the Philippines. Larios has been broken down the last couple of rounds and was knocked down in the seventh round. Pacquiao right in front of him now, looking for his opportunity to land a power shot. Larios still in there now. His legs are still a little bit sloppy. He's not 100% recovered. Then he just sort of slipped that time. He's got to get his legs back underneath him.
Since the fourth round, Pacquiao has been doing his best work building, sustaining, popping inside, taking advantage of whenever Larios did not bring his hands all the way back. Larios is gritty and determined, but he is outgunned.
And that's the point that we tried to make at the very outset of this show, that this guy can go your full 12 rounds, can Oscar Larios, but can he stand up to the power? Well, he was dropped once by an inside shot.
Watch your hands.
And it was a flash knockdown. And he was able to jump right back up and get his standing eight count, which really gave him a chance to revive himself. And Manny Pacquiao, nice combination, right hand and the left hand. And you can see the perspiration fly at the head of Larios, but his legs are okay right now. That one's right on top of where the cut is. So he's beginning to bust up the face of Larios as well. Manny having things his way right now. Don't forget, this was a dead even fight after four. And Manny Pacquiao won 5, 6, and 7. And look at this combination.
The body shots by Pacquiao slowing Larios down to the point where he's not able to use as much of the ring as he was doing earlier. And so
there's less recovery time for him. There's less time for his to regroup. And Pacquiao is all over him.
Well, we knew that Larios would come in condition. We knew he'd be in shape. We knew in the heels of not being able to get down in weight against Israel Vasquez that this was going to be a new weight classification for him that was going to be successful, but not because of the power of Pacquiao has he been able to be successful, but he's made one whale of a fight out of it so far.
And he showed up. I mean, that right hand in round three indicated that he intended to take his best chances in here, and he's still alive.
Yeah, he is, and now Manny spins him. He wants to try and finish it now, and Larios shakes his head and says, okay, let's make it a war. That again is a mistake for Larios, but that's the nature of a prize fighter. These guys don't become boxers if they're not willing to engage, and this guy's willing to engage, and it could be to his detriment. But the long looping right hand partially blocked on the gloves of Manny Pacquiao. Pacquiao right in front of him, looking to land a power shot, and it can come from either hand, left or right, and the bell ends the eighth round. Not as big a round for Pacquiao, but certainly winning the round.
And the cut gets worse for Larios.
Let's go back to round seven for a second, Dave, and see if we can catch this knockdown now.
Larios coming in, gets caught. Short, crisp shot, the right hook as Pacquiao came toward him after he missed. Larios missed, Pacquiao came right to him. See the surge inside? You make the guy miss, you make him pay.
Great job for our director, Abbott Ramos, and producer Frank Belmont catching that for us, because I couldn't see it because actually Larios' body was in the way. I didn't see what happened. I saw his head move, and then I saw him go down. So that clearly shows it. Great job by our producers, director, our videotape, our slow-mo guys. Super job in there, guys. So we finally got a chance to see exactly what it was, that short, crisp right hand by Manny Pacquiao. All right, we move to the ninth round. Again, this is scheduled for 12. Bob Sheridan here with Dave Bontempo, our principals, Manny Pacquiao, in the white trunks with his back to you now. Oscar Larios of Mexico in the blue trunks. Came in here in great shape, paid the price like a Spartan, went to Japan to train in this time zone for 5 or 6 weeks. Came down here to adjust to the humidity in this area, and there's plenty of it inside in spite of the fact this arena is now air-conditioned. It's still very warm under the lights here. This is round number nine action. Manny tries to go to the body downstairs. He makes Larios miss. Larios is not as accurate with his punches now because there is a fatigue factor, and most of that is because of the power shots of Manny.
When you can get to the body enough, and all of a sudden, you can't line up your shots so well. But Pacquiao is zooming in on target practice here.
A nice shot again with a left hand. It's just a little bit afternoon time here on a Sunday in the Philippines. And I know it's late on the East Coast of the United States and in the middle of the Saturday evening on the West Coast of the U.S., but nobody's shutting their sets off, no matter where you're watching around the world. This is an interesting fight, and there's millions involved for Manny because November at the MGM in Las Vegas is waiting for him. The third fight with Eric Morales. That's one that, as I mentioned, Bob Arum is holding his tongue right now in his cheek, hoping that Manny comes out of this unscathed.
People always hate after a fight is announced to see the guy take an interim fight because all kinds of things can happen, like a headbutt right here that can knock you back for a little while.
And taking a, what they call a tune-up fight, this is more than a tune-up opponent. Larios, a former world champ, he was carefully picked, and that's part of the profession of boxing, but this guy is in great shape and has come here to fight, and not an easy task for a guy as a war hero.
No such thing as a tune-up fight. Usually you get a tune-up and oil change and you get your whole car redone.
That's Zab Judah. Carlos Baldomir surprised him. Look at this, the hand speed of Pacquiao on the night. And now Manny goes with that left-hand power sleeve. Right hand in the face, trying to position for a power shot. Feints around, rolls around to his right. Larios doing his best to hang in there to mount some sort of offense. Blood trickles from the left thigh as Manny touches him up again with the right hand. And he goes to the left hand lead this time, and that's what he's famous for. Nice straight left hand again, and here it comes again. A combination of punches by Manny. And the face is really busting up of Oscar Larios.
Yeah, Pacquiao's punch percentage is up a lot in this round. He's getting through and getting through.
And the bell ends the night. But Pacquiao just took command from round five on in a seesaw battle in the first four rounds, with Larios winning 1 and 3 and Pacquiao taking 2 and 4. This is unofficial, but there's no question from 5 through 9, it's been all Manny Pacquiao.
And they better take a good look at Larios. He's utterly exhausted. He's going to have to convince people that he can stay in this fight, because Pacquiao is wearing him down, getting some big shots through, and when a guy gets exhausted, there go his defenses. And Larios' defenses were not up in the second half of that ninth round. Hopefully for him, the rest will help a lot, but Pacquiao has an excellent chance to get this thing stopped.
A Manny Pacquiao fight here in Araneta is like New Year's Eve in any other city in the world. Boxing is king in the Philippines. Here we go, round number 10. Remember, scheduled for 12. But Bruce McTavish knows that Larios has taken a lot of punishment, and nobody dreamed, really, that it would go beyond 3 or 4 or 5 rounds. We knew that if it got beyond 3 or 4 or 5, that things might turn in favor of Larios. And what we knew was not exactly accurate, because it hasn't gone in favor. In fact, Manny has the reach down, and he's done a terrific job in controlling 5 through 9.
We did predict on Filipino TV, though, this week, that there would be a lot of rounds to this fight. Didn't quite know how they would shake out. Larios' conditioning has enabled him to stay here, and it shows the effect of going away, focusing on one objective, spending several weeks getting used to where you're going to fight, and then bringing your heart.
Make no mistake about it, even though Manny's out boxing in the past 4 or 5 minutes, and he's landing big shots now, but there is no quickness, Larios. You're going to have to knock him down to knock him out to try and win this fight. I mean, he's got it on the score sheets right now. Manny can't lose the fight by decision, in my opinion, right now. Oh, look at that blasting shot. But the question really is, how much longer can Larios take this kind of punishment, and how much longer will Bruce McTavish allow him to take it? As long as he's throwing the shots and he's able to defend himself, it goes on. The eye does not look good whatsoever on Oscar Larios, and you wonder how much he can see out of that left eye, but this guy doesn't quit. He keeps throwing punches, thus he doesn't give the ref a chance to stop the fight.
That's why Pacquiao spins, moves to the right, fires shots to the vulnerable eye area, and keeps the pressure coming on. But for Larios, this has been a classic example of you can will yourself not to get knocked out. And right now, he is willing himself to stay as much of this fight as he can.
And for that, you give him all the credit in the world. He's a courageous boxer at the last minute of this 10th round. Manny would like to finish it if he possibly can. But he doesn't show great impatience to me, though. You know, not an urgency like, I gotta knock this guy out.
I've got some patience there. No need to lunge. No need to let the other guy get lucky. Because if you do, the guy can catch you coming in.
Manny up on his toes. He caught with a pretty good looping right hand right there, but it didn't hurt him at all. A couple of light lefts thrown by Manny. There's a strong left, and then the spinning move. I love that move by Larios. And when he does that, he throws his right hand right on top of that eye of Larios. And pretty soon, it becomes even more and more major factor in the possible ending of this fight. Pacquiao just outboxing him now. We talk about conditioning. We had questions whether he was in great shape. Well, those questions have been answered. Pacquiao did focus. He is in shape, and everything Freddie Roach told us is true. The guy was ready to fight.
That trip to L.A. for a few weeks was a bountiful move for Pacquiao. It's interesting, you have to go away from your own country to get ready to come back into your own country to fight. He was willing to do that, and that was a key play for him.
But I think when the fans watching saw the footage that we had of, you know, the crowd around him, look at this, it's all Pacquiao now.
Yep. Takes a short right hand from Larios, and then he's able to turn around from here. Larios is courageous, comes in, but the body shots of Pacquiao have been a big factor in the fight. Plus, he gets Larios moving straight back and then drills it.
Well, I have it scored 98-90 with Pacquiao winning all of the rounds from 5 through 10. And they seesawed in the first four rounds of the fight. But for Larios, that was important because everybody that you talked to from the Larios people, you know, Edson Reynoso and his manager, Rafael Mendoza, all said if he can survive three, he can maybe hang in there for 12. And now he comes back strong enough. And again, I got to give great credit to Cutman Miguel Diaz from my hometown in Las Vegas. He's one of the great cutmen in the world. And it's a good thing they brought him here because Larios has needed it from the get-go.
When your cut man can do that for you, and then you can cooperate by not getting hit in the same place for a round, the coagulants can kick in, and then you can do a good job of staying in the fight. That being said, he still can't mount enough offense against the Pac-Man, who now goes downstairs with the right hooks and is opening up with the good speed there.
And they just exchanged the lead hands. How about that? Pacquiao, when he comes in the attack, and he jumps around to his right, makes it very tough. And look at Larios, he continues to hang in there. Manny throwing a lot of punches, but Larios amazes me with his ability to hang in there. And that's his conditioning again, which we don't want to belabor the point. He was hurt with that body shot. Yeah, his leg's a little bit loose. But look at, he loads up and knocks the fucking other right hand. He will not quit, David.
Now Pacquiao moving in with more body shots and trying to get over the top. And he's in that fine line. He wants to go for a knockout, but you know what? He's safely ahead in the cards, so it's got to be a perfect scenario for Pacquiao, and it's getting better now.
Look at that combination of punches. Three-punch combination. Bang with the left hand. Back with the right hand. Back with the counter shot again. Now, you could say, you know, I'm giving him credit, but Larios is in better shape at this stage than Eric Morales was in the last fight in which Pacquiao won the fight. So certainly, we got to give that credit to Larios because, you know, we're leaning on Manny because I suppose we're influenced a little bit by the property of the Philippines. And he's such a superstar, such a great kid, and we've had so much fun with him this week. But in reality, I have great, great admiration for what Larios has been able to do with this kid. During the course of this fight,
fought with a lot of guts. He's fighting well on the road. We're talking about no pressure on him, so he's come out there and trusted his chin, trusted his conditioning, and hung in there as long as he could, as best he can do that. And what separates them now is the execution and the talent level of Pacquiao.
And there's a difference there. The power, and you said it, not only the execution, but the pure talent of Manny Pacquiao. Forget about his desire, which there's no question about that. Closing seconds now, the 11th round, and nobody really expected this to be going to 12. Look at this. The crowd got their money's worth here, and Araneta, no matter how it comes down, in the final round.
Last round.
Take a look at Pacquiao taking a right hand, which is how you should fight the southpaw. Then he comes back and delivers the goods to the body of Larios. And if Larios had not trained properly, he would not have withstood these shots. And Larios has used a little height and reach and played it well.
Well, we're ready to go to number 12 at Araneta Coliseum in Quezon City, Manila, in the Philippines.
This is round 12.
All right, here we go. This is round number 12, the 12th and final round of the fight. Can Larios hang in there? He needs a knockout if he's going to win. It's not likely that'll happen. But the people appreciate his effort here against Manny Pacquiao, the gifted little guy from the Philippines. Manny would love to finish this off with a knockout. Let's see if he can do it in round number 12. He's on the assault. He clipped him with a good shot. Larios tries to stay up on his toes. Body shots now by Manny Pacquiao. Manny bobs and weaves. Dave, you're going to go in there when the fight's over and try to talk to both of these guys. I'm going to look forward to that and see what Manny had to say about Larios hanging in as long as he has, and what Larios has to say about Manny.
Right.
Yeah, about how well he'll do down the road, because these guys have fought, showed something that for Larios, having a little bit of height and reach and using it well, plus the conditioning, has kept him in the fight. For Pacquiao, working inside, a little bit of a taller guy, and doing what was necessary will give him this win.
Manny get clipped there at about the two-minute mark, remaining with a pretty good shot, but the legs of Larios are a little bit out right now. You know that he's very heavy in the heels, although he tries to get up on his toes, but he's in magnificent shape coming into this fight, and he really, really worked hard. And the pace of this fight is another thing. I mean, there's been nonstop action in this fight from the get-go.
Good action, and you know, people who are going to sit there and compare now what happens with Pacquiao, Morales, etc. He has walked into a good number of right hands tonight, and against somebody with more power, there will be that speculation about, will that hurt him in future fights? So there's a lot of grist for the mill when you look at Pacquiao's future fights. And for Larios, he has performed well on a world stage. He went away, he trained, he fought well. He will get another fight on the heels of this, because you can be a beneficiary of low expectations.
Oh, there he goes. Coming with a series of punches that put him down. The count of the four and five will take the standing eight count. That was just an accumulation of punches. And now it's kind of academic what might happen in this fight. Manny Pacquiao had him down and would like to knock him out here in the last 30 seconds of this fight. But Larios, he just wants to survive this round now. He throws a shot. There's no quitting, Larios, and he's taken two more big shots. But he throws his own. He ties up Manny Pacquiao. He's not in strictly survival mode. He wants to try to finish strong. Manny's got the smile on his face, and now we're inside of 10 seconds to go. How about this? Oscar Larios apparently will survive the fight. He won't get the decision, but he's made it a great war and a wonderful prize fight. Listen to the crowd reaction. I scored a 118-108 in favor of Pacquiao, and I would expect that the three judges will have it someplace in that ballpark. It was a terrific win, in my opinion, for Manny Pacquiao. We'll still have to make that official, of course. Now, what you've seen is a tremendous prize fight by two consummate professional athletes. A great job of that man, Miguel Diaz. Closing round action. Watch the knockdown. You see, he catches Larios kind of off balance, because Larios was not into survival mode. He was in attack mode, and it was a left hand. That straight left hand, but it was an accumulation of punches that put him down. Watch this. You'll see Pacquiao. There's the same series, but a different angle. See, there was a left hand, and then another left hand that put the head back, and then a real strong left hand. So it was three pretty solid left hands, finished by one that crashed on the high right side of his cheek, to more or less put an exclamation point on the fight. Dave Bontempo has gone into the ring, and when I see that he's with Manny Pacquiao, we'll make an attempt to do the interview in there. Really a sensational effort for Oscar Larios, in that he basically, Manny came in here as 7-1 favorite. Larios not given much of a chance even to survive three or four rounds in this fight. And he came in tremendous physical condition and made a great fight out of it. And again, we're going to make an attempt to talk to both Manny Pacquiao, who is going to be the victor, and Oscar Larios, who we don't think will score too many points. Again, I had to score 118-108 in favor of Manny Pacquiao. We've got to get the official announcement. All right, this is the way it started out. And Oscar Larios came on strong from the beginning. Round number two, Pacquiao began to land shots and started to score punches. You see that clean right hand by Manny. Now Manny starts to accumulate punches here. And notice the pace as we show you the recap of the fight as we go to round number three. Larios has a pretty good round. And in fact, at one stage here, I thought that Larios may have had Manny in a bit of trouble as his legs began to dip. But a cut occurred by the left eye of Larios also in the third round. So it was a back and forth third round. But we eventually gave that third round to Oscar Larios. And then you come up to round number five. And from this point on, Manny Pacquiao really takes over. He shows his boxing skill, dipping under punches. And we move to six, and it's more of Pacquiao. But notice how there's no quit in Oscar Larios. Larios just can't seem to land a real clean punch from this point, and it's because of the slick movement of Manny Pacquiao. And in the seventh round, it's more Manny, and he goes down for the first time in the fight. He was down again in the 12th round, as you know, but that was the first time he was down in the seventh round. Kind of a flash knockdown by a short, crisp punch. And look at this, it's all Manny Pacquiao. A terrific job at the end of the round. And here we go to round eight as Manny continues the assault. And this shows you the conditioning that Larios was in, because Larios actually started out on the assault in the early going. And look at the way Manny came back as we switched to round nine and then to 10. And at this stage, it's starting to become academic as Larios hangs in there and lands his share of punches, but nowhere near the amount of punches that Manny Pacquiao was landing at this stage of the fight. Manny is really in total command at this stage of the fight, but notice again, no quit into round 11 of Oscar Larios. And Larios is very tired now, but every time he gets hit, he continues to come on a chopping right hand. He blasts him again. This is just sensational stuff. And again, it's Larios who makes it, because there's no quit in this guy. He's in tremendous physical shape. And lesser fighters would have wilted by this stage. And in round 12, Pacquiao just puts the pressure on. He's really gunning for a knockout. And eventually he is able to knock Oscar Larios down. So we have to make this official. So let's go to the voice of champions in Michael Buffer. Let's make it official, Michael.
Ladies and gentlemen, before we go to the scorecards, a round of applause for two warriors who stepped into this ring here tonight. They never quit. They both fought with the heart of a lion and the courage of a champion. Umberto Borgoni scores it 117-110. Daniel Vandeville, 118-108. Noferat Svicharwin, 120-106. To the winner and still champion, the Fighting Kind of the Philippines, Manny Pacman Pacquiao.
So Dave is getting into position. Dave, as soon as you have Manny Pacquiao, we'll get the interview underway.
All right, Manny, congratulations on this fight. When did you sense you were starting to break him down?
I'm not expecting him, I'm gonna knock him down. But I do my best in the fight. I do my best to show the people.
He ended up being a very tough guy. What were the things he did that you had to adjust to?
On the fourth round, I make him adjustment to my style, because he's too strong too, and he's a good fighter inside.
What did you feel about fighting at home this week with all the attention of these people and coming out here today?
I'm sorry?
The fighting in front of your hometown fans, what did this feel like for you?
I'm very proud that the fight is here in the Philippines, and I'm very excited to show the people that my fight is here in Araneta Coliseum. And I would like to thanks to all my countrymen, to all their support and prayers. And I hope you always support with us.
You fought here. A lot of people think now it's Eric Morales. What is your thought? Do you want that? And how do you feel about it all?
The next one is Morales on November 18th. So Morales 3 is going to be in Las Vegas. So to all my countrymen, and hope you always support me.
Let's get an assessment from Freddie Roach. You were here all week. Freddie, your assessment of Manny's performance here.
It was a great fight. Larios came to fight. I mean, I didn't think he'd go the distance. He proved me wrong. He's very game. He had me worried in the third round, and he fought a great fight. It was a great fight.
What was the biggest thing Manny did to turn this fight in his favor?
He stayed off the ropes, and he boxed in the middle of the ring, and that's what was the key.
All right, so that training out in Los Angeles helped when he came back here.
Definitely, and as I said, Manny's a machine. He's 12-14. He trained for 12 hard rounds, and he proved it.
Okay, congratulations to both of you. Good work all the way around. Manny, you want to say something else?
Mabuhay, Philippines, and kanina nag-English ako eh. Ngayon, magpapasalamat naman ako ng taos puso sa Panginoon. Magpapasalamat po ako sa lahat. Sa lahat po ng pumunta rito, maraming salamat po. Ang tagumpay ko po ay hindi lamang para sa akin, kundi para po sa ating mga mamamayang Pilipino. Peace be with you all, mga kababayan ko. Ang laban ko na to ay laban nating lahat. Maraming salamat po sa inyong lahat.
Quickly, what was that in English?
Thank you very much to all their support, I said. And, at saka maraming salamat po sa lahat ng mga nag-sponsor, Smart, at sa lahat.
Okay, you got everybody thanked and you did a great job here. Pac-Man, we look forward to seeing you again. That's the performance over here.
All right, Dave is going to try to get into position now to get a few words with Oscar Larios.
Where's Matt?
And it would be very interesting to hear exactly what Larios has to say as you take a look at this action to close out the fight. This was a knockdown at the very end of the fight when, really by exhaustion, Larios couldn't take any more punishment and accumulation of punches.
Dave Oscar,
there he goes.
Tremendous performance for you tonight. You trained in Japan. What are your thoughts on this contest here? We'll get translation.
Yes. Well, in reality, I was well trained.
Yo quería ganar esta pelea. Quería derrotar a Pacquiao.
I really wanted to beat Pacquiao. I wanted to win this fight.
Me preparé bien y esta vez hice todo lo posible hasta el último esfuerzo, pero perdí entre un gran campeón.
I was well prepared. I gave 100%, but at the end of the night, I lost to a great champion.
All the attention was on Manny Pacquiao, of course, this week. Did that take some pressure off of you?
Toda la atención tuvo Manny Pacquiao toda la semana. ¿Te quitó presión eso?
No, yo venía bien preparado mentalmente y físicamente. No se pudo.
I was well prepared physically and mentally. That didn't matter.
Y antes que nada, quiero darle las gracias nuevamente a Pacquiao por la oportunidad. Y salama a todo Filipinas.
He says, before anything else, I want to give Manny Pacquiao a thank you for giving me the opportunity. And salamat po, Manila, Philippines.
In the third round, you landed a good right hand and a left hook. Did you think you may have hurt him?
En el tercer round, ¿crees que lo lastimaste? Le tiraste un gancho pero arriba, un cruzado.
En el tercer round, yo sentí que ya lo tenía, pero como también pega duro, no me quise precipitar.
I thought in the third round I might have hurt him, but at the same time, he's very strong and hits very hard and dangerous, so I had to be careful.
Who wins Pacquiao Morales?
¿Quién va a ganar Pacquiao Morales?
Todavía no sé. El que se prepare mejor.
Whoever prepares himself better. He really doesn't know. He can't say.
Okay.
Por favor, mando un saludo para Julapan, Colima, para todos los Larios y para todos los Moya, para mis hijas y para mi esposa. Adiós. Gracias. Okay. Filipinas, salama.
Salama, Filipinas.
All right, a salute to the Philippines. Great sportsmanship on both sides. Back to you, Colonel.
All right, Dave Bontempo. So it was a sensational night of boxing. In the history of boxing, it may not be the same as the thriller in Manila of some 31 years ago, but as far as the boxing fans in Manila are concerned, Manny Pacquiao is king of the world. Listen to the crowd. Listen to the ovation. They absolutely love Manny Pacquiao. A lot of questions were answered. Lesser men may not have been able to come to their hometown and do what Manny Pacquiao did. He wasn't distracted. He performed admirably. He was up against a guy that was well conditioned, and a wonderful effort by Oscar Larios. So for Manny Pacquiao, while his star has already risen here in the Philippines, Dave, I'd like to get a final comment from you, because we have a rising star in the area of the total picture in boxing, and a star that's already in the sky here in the Philippines.
I love how he reacted, Colonel, after the initial assault, after he got hit. Pacquiao went inside, he countered, and he showed that killer instinct, and he continues to be humble as a superstar. And only in an international competition like this do you see the sportsmanship we saw from both guys after this fight. A pleasing effort and a tease for Pacquiao Morales.
So we look forward to Pacquiao and Morales. We look forward to many, many more fights of Manny Pacquiao. Again, the people in the Philippines on this Sunday afternoon go home very, very proud, very, very happy. And you people on the world scene have had a great opportunity to see exactly what Manny Pacquiao is all about. A rising star in boxing. A great, great night. We want to thank everybody that's involved. For our production coordinator, Frank Belmont, our director has been Abbott Ramos. For everybody at ABS and CBN Broadcast Company, especially Peter Musni, who helped us so much this week as our coordinating producer. So, for Manny Pacquiao Promotions and ABS-CBN Broadcasting Company, Belmonte Productions, and on behalf of Dave Montempo, my broadcast partner, I'm the Colonel Bob Sheridan saying, thanks for joining us. I hope you enjoyed watching this as much as we enjoyed bringing it to you. So long from Philippines. Good night, everybody. And good afternoon, everybody here on this side of the world. I'm the Colonel Bob Sheridan saying, see you next time. Bye-bye.